the radio, the print ads, the acting business in the state of Utah, my incredible mother, Susie McCarty.
I'm up here in my bare feet, by the way. For those of you who can see my bare feet, my shoe broke, and I couldn't put one shoe on with one shoe off. So, hi everybody. and you know what? It doesn't bother me at all, so I hope it doesn't bother you. that's a great way to open up my speech, isn't it? The person that got me into this business was my grandmother. And she was born and raised and educated in Holland. And we were living in Riverton, Utah. And she was someone that to deal with was like, oh my God, I just thought, she was just a force in our lives. I mean, she took over everything. I mean, what we'd wear, what we'd eat. But she was a character, and she was very liberal. So we had lots of fun. We danced to music at the house in Riverton, Carry On. So she had a big influence in the fact that somehow or another, I knew that I wanted to be in the acting and modeling business. And she hired me for my first fashion show that I modeled in when I was 15 years old. And I can still feel that feeling that I had when I walked down that runway. And it sounds so egotistical, but it was just so amazing. And I remember she said, whatever you do, look out into the audience. Look out, somebody way back there, I'll look you right in the eye. Bring the audience into you. And so many people, when you see them speak, they talk to everybody that's up front. But I know that you're way back there. I'm aware of you, and I am so happy that you are all here. I am so grateful. And to see faces that I haven't seen for so long. And the bottom line is, and I want you all to remember this, I could have never, ever have done what I did without you. And that is the truth. You need to have talent, right? If somebody wants to book somebody, you better have some really good actors, great voiceover people. We have the best kids. We even have babies and ads for CCMI. CCMI was one of my best clients, and my first, it was Grizzly Adams, I think. Yeah, Grizzly Adams was my first show for me putting actors to work and all that. And oh my God, my life, I've had such a great life, I can't even begin to tell you. I wake up every morning in gratitude. And let me tell you, one of the reasons why I'm standing here is because of you. I mean, you're such incredible talent. Your voiceover work, your modeling, and not only that, but the people that have worked for me in the office. We've had the most incredible people. Right here, Michelle. She has been a trooper. I remember you were doing reception work in the salon, right? And she did a great job in there, and I thought, I really need somebody. So I went over and I said, would you like this job? And here she is, and she's still there. And she runs the show, and she does an incredible job. And thank you, Michelle. I'm deeply grateful. I grew up on a farm town called Riverton, Utah. And the loves that I had then were animals. I had everything, sheep, you know, little baby cows, rabbits, horses, whatever kind of animal that lives on a farm, dogs, cats. My life was about animals, and I adored them and loved them. And the hardest part would be that, because it was during World War II, my grandpa would go out and get one of the little cows or one of the bunny rabbits, and we'd kill it and skin it and clean it, and then we'd be eating it on our dinner table that night. And I was...
Talk about the fashion industry, not about
pulling it. But anyway, my grandmother, she worked at Keith O'Brien's in ready-to-wear, and she asked me if I'd like to model in a fashion show, and I was 15 years old. And I said, Grandma, I've never modeled in my life. I really didn't know what to do. And she said, but you have a great walk, you have great posture. The only thing you need to do is look out into your audience, bring your audience into you, and have fun, have a good time. Well, I had so much fun, I could hardly wait to do another show. And in the years, I've done hundreds and hundreds of fashion shows. So it paid off, plus the fact I realized that Salt Lake City needed a booker, an agent, representing people, getting people into TV, in the film. We had, what was the great TV show that came here? Thanks, honey. I did take notes, and somebody gave me some notes here, but I left all my notes at home, so I'm winging it. And most of my life, I've been winging it. It's worked so far. Hold on just a minute, okay. It's a good thing that I have a director over here. But the main reason I'm up here is to thank all of you. You are incredible talent. Incredible people who have hired our talent. I could never have been doing this without you. And there were so many of you that were on time, you'd show up, you'd be prepared. The people, the ad agencies, you know, everybody that hired you, people in film, would always tell me what great talent we have. And so you all helped make this market what it is. And I am deeply grateful to each of you. You can go back all those years. How many years has it been now? 50 years.